Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are going to solve equations using inverse operations. Let's start with something we already know. The last skill was about forming equations. Remember I asked you something like this. I'm thinking of a number, I double it and get 27.2, and I asked you to form an equation from that statement. Pause the video and double check you can do that. So hopefully you would have thought, I'm thinking of a number, well let me call it x, I'm going to double it, so using the flowchart I'm going to multiply by 2 and I get 2x. I know when I do that I get the answer 27.2, and I know these two things are equal, so my equation that I formed would be 2x is going to equal 27.2. Now, what's different about this video? Well, the word solve. And by that, someone's going to say to us, what was my number? That's the only difference in this particular skill. Before, we just formed the equation. Now, we've got to find the original number. We have to find x. How would you do this? You had thought of a number, you doubled it, and you got 27.2. How would you find what the number was? Well, I know what I'd do. I would half or divide 27.2 by 2, wouldn't you? Because you'd undo or do the inverse operation or the opposite operation to multiplication by 2. So what I would do is I would take the answer 27.2 and I would divide it by 2. And I would get myself 13.6. And that is my x. X must be 13.6. So let's try and link this flowchart up to the algebra. In this particular skill, I'm going to use the flowchart a lot, and I'm off at the side going to write the algebra that's associated with it and the forming equation steps. Over time, we're just going to start using this, but at the start, it's really handy to have both. So I knew that 2x was equal to 27.2. I wrote that down. In order to go backwards, I divided by 2. So I divided my equation by 2. I divided 27.2 by 2 and I divided 2x by 2 to go backwards in this direction, and I would get myself that x is equal to 13.6. That was my number. X is 13.6. Double check it obviously before you go on. If you took 13.6 and you doubled it, yeah, you would get 27.2. I found x by doing the inverse operation, and the flowchart was dead handy there just to, in my head, make it easy for me to work out what was the inverse operation. Right, let's try another one, maybe with some more steps. Now, I want you to pause the video, and firstly, can you write the equation that comes from that statement? Pause, check, you can write the equation. Well, I would have said the thinking of a number was x, I triple it and I get 3x, then I subtract 5 and I would get 3x, subtract 5. I'm told that when I do all that, I get that this thing is equal to 37. So the equation that I could form is 3x subtract 5 is equal to 37. And that was from the last video, the skill in the last video. But now I'm saying, what was my number, i.e. what was x? What would you do? Well, I know what I'd do. I would do the inverse operation to get myself back to the number that must be x. What is the inverse or opposite to subtracting 5? Well, if I'm going backwards, it must be to add 5. 37 add 5 is 42. How would I get back from here? What is the inverse or opposite to multiplying by 3? Well, it's dividing by 3. So I'm going to do 42 divided by 3. And 42 divided by 3, you could do it by short division, it is the answer 14. So I found x must be 14. There you go, I found it. Now, it's just really useful at this stage. I'm going to write each line of working down. You see this here? That's my first line of working. When I are going backwards along here, I'm adding 5 to both sides of my equation. And I get myself 3x is equal to 42. So my next line of working is 3x is equal to 42. And then what did I do to move along here? I divided both sides by 3. So I divided both sides here by 3 and I got my answer that x is equal to 14. Here's the flowchart way using inverse operations. This is something we're building towards and we're going to start doing from the next skill onwards. So I just want to show you how I get the 2. But the answer is x is 14. Check it before you go on. triple 14. If you triple 14, you get yourself 42. Subtract 5, you get yourself 37. You're done. And that's your answer. What's your number? 14. Pause the video. Have a go at this one. I'm thinking of a number. That's x. I'm going to half it. So I'm dividing by 2. I get the expression x over 2. And I know the answer is 13.3. How would I get back? How would I undo dividing by 2? I'd multiply by 2. And 13.3 multiplied by 2 is going to equal to 26.6. And that's my number. What would the algebra have been, just out of interest? That line would have been x over 2 is equal to 13.3. If I multiplied the both sides by 2, as I did to undo this divide by 2 here, I get myself x is equal to 26.6. This is exactly equivalent to this. It's just the way we're going to start writing it in future. Pause the video. Have a go at this one. I'm thinking of a number. I subtract 5 and I get the expression x subtract 5. I'm told I get 5.4 as a number answer when I do that. So to go backwards, to find my original number, I'm going to do the inverse or the opposite of subtracting 5, which is adding 5, which will get me 10.4. The algebra behind this first line here is x subtract 5 is equal to 5.4. What have I done to go this process? What have I done to move in this direction? I've added 5 to both sides. So I'm just going to say I added 5 there and I added 5 there. And I got myself x is therefore equal to 10.4. Done. Pause the video and have a go at these two. Okay, we faced this question before where we formed the equation, but we weren't told to find the number. Let's see if we can do that. I'm thinking of a number, x. I double it, multiply by 2, get 2x. I then add 3, and I get myself 2x, add 3. But I'm told that's equal to 10.4, so these two are equal. To find what my number is, let me use inverse operations to get back to what x must be. The opposite of adding 3 is to subtract 3. So let me do 10.4 subtract 3, which is 7.4. And then let me do the opposite of multiplying by 2, which is dividing by 2. And I would get myself the answer, x is equal to 3.7. Great, we found it. Now, I just want to show you what the algebra would be at the side here to solve it, not using the flowchart. It would be this. 2x add 3 is 10.4, first line. 2x is therefore 7.4 because we subtracted 3. That was our first step. Our last step was to divide by 2 and we got x is 3.7. This here we're going to do in the next skill solely without the flowchart anymore. But for now, the flowchart's all right. All right, the next one. What did you get? Well, I'm thinking of a number x. This time I added the 3 first and I got x add 3. Then I doubled all of that expression. So remember, it's 2 brackets x add 3 because I doubled the whole thing. Again, I got 10.4. Now I've got to think to myself, how do I get x? How do I find out what that must be? Inverse operations. The opposite of multiplying by 2 is dividing by 2. And I would get myself 5.2 because 10.4 divided by 2 is that. Then I would subtract 3, which is the opposite of adding 3. And I would get the answer x is 2.2. In equation form, it would look like that. And you can see we got different answers, and it did the order doubling first and then adding 3 means that when you go backwards, you must subtract 3 and then half it. When you add 3 first and double it to undo it, to do the inverse, you must first divide by 2 and then subtract 3. Okay, last one. Pause the video. Do have a go at these. Okay, I'm thinking of a number, x. Using my flowchart, I divide it by 3. Mathematician writes that as x over 3. Then I add 11. And I get the expression x over 3, add 11. I know that I get 12 when I do that. To find what x is, let's undo the steps. The opposite of adding 11 is subtracting 11. 12 subtract 11 is 1. And the opposite of dividing by 3 is multiplying by 3. 1 multiplied by 3 gives me x is 3. Just showing you the algebra steps. That's how it would have looked, and we would have got x is 3 the same way. Last one looks similar, but I added the 11 first and subtract and divided by 3 afterwards. So here I start with x, I first add 11 to get the expression x add 11. Then I'm going to divide that whole thing by 3. So x add 11, all of that divided by 3. We can write a bracket there if we want. We know this is equal to 12 again, but let's undo this procedure. The opposite to dividing by 3 is multiplying by 3. 12 multiplied by 3 is 36. And the opposite of adding 11 is subtracting 11, getting me 25. X must therefore equal 25, and I would have got it using algebra the exact same way. Now that was great. We've worked out how to solve quite complicated problems. Fantastic. In future though, we're not going to use this flowchart. We're going to just use this algebra. It's neater, nicer, and easier to write. And that's what the next skill is going to be about. So we're going to just start off here. I'm going to give you a problem like this, and we're going to work out how to find x.